Tom, great to be here on Virgin Voyages, your first ship. I spoke to the CEOs of Royal Caribbean and Carnival this morning. They told me they're not worried about the competitive threat from Virgin Voyages. What's your response? How do you steal market share from these two companies that really dominate this multi-billion dollar industry?
Well, we think about this as really trying to expand the entire travel business. You know, we wouldn't be in this industry if it wasn't a great industry, great guest satisfaction, incredible value for money. But we think about Virgin Voyages as expanding the entire travel market by offering an adult experience on the high seas, delivered in a way that only Virgin Voyages can do.
Delta variant has hit bookings for some of the publicly listed cruise lines. What do bookings look like for your first sailings coming up in October?
You know, the good thing about launching now is that there is pent-up demand. We're seeing a lot of folks. We need to get out there and showcase our ship so people know who we are, people know who Virgin is, but they haven't experienced Virgin Voyages. And we just had a successful season in the UK. Great rave reviews. People are loving the dining. They're loving the entertainment. They're loving this adult-only experience. So we've got to let that settle in, and those bookings will come. So we're happy with where we are today, but obviously we've got opportunity in the future.
Over $1 billion spent to launch this Virgin Voyages brand. Bain Capital, the private equity firm, is your largest shareholder. Are there plans to take Virgin Voyages public? Last time you said there were. A SPAC in the cards, or do you want to ultimately get acquired by one of the larger cruise lines?
Well, for right now, we're really focused on launching this brand. And it is about launching. We've got the Scarlet Lady launching next week, followed by two more ships next year. So we're focused on creating a great experience. That liquidity event, whatever it will be, whether it's taking the company public or an acquisition, that will come in due course. Right now, we've got to showcase to the world what it's like to set sail the Virgin way and create that love. We know that we have something very, very special here, something very special for that adult market, and people are going to love us.
On Wall Street, the big question is, how do you get that younger traveler on board? They've been historically a bit more reluctant to cruise. What's your strategy?
Well, I think we've got a unique experience for them. It's focused on the adults. It's great dining. People love those dining experiences. It's great entertainment. And we've got to make them feel comfortable that they can be safe and secure here. So we have spent the past 18 months developing protocols, procedures to make them feel safe. We've invested in new technology like Atmosphere, which is an air purification system, kills 99.9% of all bacteria and viruses that are in the air. And then we're doubling down on vaccines. Vaccines are a game changer. So we're requiring 100% of our sailors and 100% of our crew to be vaccinated. And as an additional step, we're making all of our folks be tested before they get on board the ship. And if you think about the combination of all those factors, this is the safest possible way to travel. This is safer than going to a hotel, to a restaurant. It's safer than going grocery shopping. Everyone around you has been vaccinated.